Has it ever occurred with you during coding interviews that you have been asked some question and you have absolutely no clue how to move forward with that? Hey guys, this is me Rachit Jain and welcome to yet another video on the Google Code Jam series in which I am talking about the art of problem solving. I pick up questions from the Google Code Jam competitions and then solve them with you so that you learn the art of problem solving and how to deal with new problems when you are asked. So guys, before we move forward, let's hear the message from our sponsors. Today's video is being sponsored by TechKick, which is a massive community for competitive programming and hiring related events. They are having a very great coding event coming up, which is having like lots of prizes up to 1 crore Indian rupees. And you can see that the champion will get 3 lakhs and then they also have prizes for other runner-ups. The good thing that I feel about this is that they also have prizes for best female coders, as well as the top 5,000 performers will get 500 rupees gift vouchers. If you also perform good in this Code Gladiators event, there are so many companies, IT companies, which are doing hiring for the top performers from this event. So you also get an exposure to an hiring chance. The schedule of this round looks like they have already started with the open round. It was starting from 29th March and spanning all the way till 22nd May. If you do good in that, you move to semi-finals, which will go on from 22nd May to 3rd June. Both of these rounds are online, and if you do well in both of them, finally you will get to visit Mumbai in the Jio campus. The timelines for the final rounds are 21st June to 23rd June, as you can see. Alright guys, if you want to register for this contest, you can find the link in the description below. So the question that we'll be discussing today is that, let's say we are having a string A, B, C, D, E. So we can permute this in a variety of ways. Like we can make this as an A, B, C, E, D. Then we can also make it as an A, B, E, C, D. And probably we can also do like this. To be honest, the word A, B, C, D can be permuted in a lot of different ways. 120 to be exact. But what I'm going to do is that I'm going to remove one of the possible permutations from the 120 list that we are having. So now we have 119 permutations. To be honest, I am having those permutations. You know nothing about that list. All you know is that there were initially 120 possible permutations for A, B, C, D, E, but then I removed one of them. But you really don't know which one has been removed. And actually, that's the question. You know that there are 119 permutations and you have to ask up to 475 questions to figure out what is that missing permutations that I have removed. So I will come back to the questions part, like what kind of questions you can ask. Another thing is that if you are able to do it for 475 questions, the next task is if you can do the same in just 150 questions. So now let's like understand what these questions mean. For example, one of the possible questions that you can ask me is that, hey Rachit, just give me the first word's third character. And I will say that, okay, fine. The first word in my list is this, and the third character of that is a C. So I return C for your question of first word and third character. Another question can be, hey Rachit, give me the 119th word first character. And I will say, okay, fine, let me check. So that comes out to be a E, and here you go. So you really don't know what's going on under the hood, like what are those 119 permutations. All you can ask me are questions like these. And the question is to ask up to 475 questions and find the missing permutation that I have removed. Alright guys, so let's understand how this is working. So let's say you asked me the first character of some word, okay? Like it can be the third word, fifth word, I'm not interested in that. But let's say you picked up any one word, maybe the seventh word, and you asked me the first character and you got a D. Then you asked for the second character of the same word, you got an A. Then you asked the third, and then you asked the fourth. So you got T, A, B, and C. The important observation over here is that 4 questions per word are enough to completely identify that word, because we already know that the fifth possible character is only an E. So well, if you were like really confused as in how to move forward, this was a very big hint. So we know that 4 questions are enough for one word. We have 119 words. So in total, we will be asking 119 into 4 questions, which comes out to be 476. The downside is that we can ask up to 475 questions. So we already know that it's not going to work out. But hey, we are really doing an awesome job over here. That was a very good observation. Okay, now let's try to break this up into smaller parts. Now, let's say we are having the initial list of 120 words. Let's say we are having the initial list of 120 possible permutations. So in that list of 120 permutations, if we look out for ABCDE and ABCED, both of them will be there. EBCDA and EBCAD will also be there. Now let's say we chose the word CEBAD and that is removed from the list of 120 permutations. So now you know that there are 119 permutations in that list. And if you try to find out the counterpart for CEBDA, which is CEBAD, you won't be able to find that. So what does this mean? It means that in the list of 119 words, if we try to bucketize each word by the first three characters, we'll get multiple buckets, and each bucket will have two words in that except for one. So for example, two words will be starting with ABC, two words will start with ABC, but there will be exactly one word which will start with CEB, and that is a very important observation, and we will exploit this to finally solve this problem. So now what we are going to do is that we will be asking the first three characters of the 119 permutations that will lead to 357 questions. But once we do that, we now know that two words will start with ABC, two words will start with EBC, and so on, and there will be exactly one word which will be starting with CEB. So this means that Rachit has either removed CEBDA or CEBAD. How we are saying that? Because we know that CEB is the only bucket which exists as alone, right? So let's ask one more question now. So what will happen now is that CEBD also exists, because now we have asked one more question that give us the fourth character of this particular word, which is CEB. Now we get the fourth character and we now know that CEBD also exists. Now since we know the first four characters of that word, the only missing character is A. So we now know that CEBDA is also there in the list of 119 permutations, which rules out the possibility, and now we are only having sure short answer that CEBAD is the permutation that was missing. So we could do everything in just 358 questions. We were able to find all the missing permutation, which was CEBAD. Initially, we were doing with 476 questions, and that's a massive improvement, guys. And you have solved the first part. So guys, that's pretty great. Like, we were able to find the missing permutation in 358 questions. And the next part is about the 150 questions, like finding the missing permutation in 150 questions. And I will just give you a hint for that. And let me know in comments if you were able to solve that out. So the hint over here that I want to give you is that when you ask the first character of 119 words, it means you exhaust 119 questions. Then in those 119 words, when you get the first character back, so you'll have a list of 119 characters. 24 words or 24 characters will be A, while only 23 in that will begin with C. So what I mean by that is that 24 words will begin with A, 24 will begin with B, then 24 with D, 24 with E, but only 23 will begin with C. I mean, I'm saying all this because I know that I have removed CEBAD. So that's why I will say 23 will begin with C. But I mean, this is a hint, and it's a super massive hint, to be honest. And even during coding interviews, when the interviewer is giving you hints, don't just be lost in your own thought process. Hear out to the tips that interviewer is giving. And I think it's a very, very useful hint. Work out on this and let me know in comments if you could take this hint and finally work out through the solution wherein you can find out the missing permutation by just asking 150 questions. Alright guys, I hope you enjoyed the process of solving this particular problem, and that's all I had for this video. So about the Code Clarity contest, you can find the registration links in the description. Don't forget about the awesome prizes they have. Also, if you like this video, hit the like button. If you want to see more such videos, hit the subscribe button. Also hit the bell icon, and I'll see you next time. Till then, bye bye.